As we all know, tensions have been high between Prince Harry and the royal family ever since he stepped back from senior royal duties and moved to California with his wife Meghan Markle. Things seemed to reach a boiling point this week when actor John Stamos publicly demanded that Harry apologize to King Charles. For those just joining us, here's a brief recap of events. Last month, Harry and Meghan sat down for a bombshell interview with Oprah Winfrey where they leveled serious accusations against the royal family. They said a senior royal expressed concerns about Archie's skin color before he was born. Meghan also said she struggled with her mental health as a working royal and claimed the institution failed to help her. The interview sparked global controversy and further strained Harry's relationship with his father and brother William. In the months since, Harry has mostly stayed silent about any ongoing tensions with his family. That changed this week when John Stamos, best known for playing Uncle Jesse on Full House, inserted himself into the ongoing royal drama on Twitter. Responding to a post about tensions between Harry and the royals, Stamos wrote, "Prince Harry, now is the time to apologize to your father and issue a statement of support for the Queen. Stop dragging others into your mess and damaging the institution." Stamos's opinion seemingly came out of nowhere and shocked royal watchers, though the actor is apparently an avid royalist. His tweet took off, gaining tens of thousands of likes. It attracted commentary from other celebrities like Piers Morgan, who agreed Harry owed the royals an apology. News of Stamos's demand soon reached Harry, who was apparently affected deeply by it. This morning, Harry appeared as a guest on Good Morning America where he broke down in tears during his interview with George Stephanopoulos. Footage shows Harry becoming visibly emotional as Stephanopoulos asked how he was coping with the ongoing tensions. "It's incredibly difficult," said Harry through tears. "The things being said, especially by people like John Stamos who know nothing of what's really going on, it's heartbreaking. I'm trying to protect my family and John thinks I should apologize? I don't even know where to begin." Stephanopoulos pressed Harry on whether he regretted the Oprah interview. "No, I don't regret it," said Harry. "But I regret that it's caused even more pain for my father and brother. The institution has kept them trapped as well and they don't even realize it. All I want is for my wife and kids to be safe and to have the life they deserve. I never wanted it to be this way." When asked directly about Stamos's demand for an apology, Harry grew more emotional. "John Stamos has no idea what he's talking about. He doesn't understand anything about my family or what I've been through. For him to say I need to apologize when he has no idea of the truth or everything they put me and Meghan through, it just shows how little people understand. I'm trying to deal with real trauma and he thinks it's a joke." Harry's raw emotions clearly caught Stephanopoulos off guard, as the normally composed prince broke down sobbing at one point. Stephanopoulos gently consoled Harry and handed him tissues. Observers online were also visibly shaken by the unexpected outpouring of emotion from the prince, who is typically private about his feelings. At one point in recovering himself, Harry said, "You know, I really think I could take on John Stamos in a cage match to settle this. Don't tell Meghan I said that, though." The quip was likely an attempt to lighten the mood after Harry's intense bout of crying, but it understandably went viral online. Stephanopoulos then asked about Harry's current relationship with his father, King Charles. Harry took a deep breath before answering. "My father doesn't return my calls. He obviously believes the lies being spread instead of hearing the truth from me. I can't keep sticking my neck out and getting burnt like this while they protect people who do actual harm. All I want is to build a peaceful life for my family, but they won't let me." Since the Raw GMA interview aired this morning, the reactions have been strong. Supporters of Harry have flooded social media with messages of sympathy for the prince, while critics accuse him of further damaging the monarchy with public outbursts. Others say the interview humanized Harry in a way not seen before and showed the depth of emotion simmering just below the surface for the conflicted royal. Perhaps the most entertaining response came from John Stamos himself on Twitter. In a now-viral post, Stamos wrote, "My apologies to Prince Harry. I didn't realize the trauma he's endured or that he'd so easily kick my **** in a wrestling match. Keep fighting the good fight and go easy on the old Uncle Jesse." Stamos's humorous olive branch seems to have quelled further drama between the two for now. But this unprecedented move by Harry to sob openly on live TV shows the conflict is far from over. The firm will surely have strong reactions behind closed doors to Harry further airing dirty laundry in public. And of course, this all leads to more questions about Harry and Meghan's future relationship with the royal family as well as their ongoing media projects. Both have stated their desire to achieve financial independence, which some see as contradicting their frequent public statements criticizing the institution. For now, all eyes remain on the ongoing tensions across the pond. I'm sure there's plenty more royal tea still to be spilled. Tune in next time for more exclusive coverage of all things Buckingham Palace. In the meantime, let me know your thoughts on today's bombshell interview in the comments below. Until then, stay tuned, Royal Watchers.